Hello, my name is Vladimir Liberzon, and I am Research and Development Director of the company Spider Project Team that developed the software that we will discuss in this presentation. Spider Project is a powerful and very functional project management software that was developed in 1993, and since then constantly improved. New versions of Spider Project are launched each month, and now it is used in 36 countries. In Russia, it is most popular project management software. It is used in most large-scale projects, programs like preparation of 2014 Winter Olympic Games, construction of all stadiums for 2018 FIFA World Cup, and a lot of other projects that are very prominent. Spider Project is an integrated software that includes everything that can be needed in project, program, and portfolio management. It includes all traditional methods and tools, and has a lot of unique features. Some of them we will discuss in this presentation. And we are proud that Spider Project is the only software that optimizes resource constraint schedules. The schedules created by Spider Project are usually much shorter than the schedules created by other tools for the same project. Unique features of Spider Project includes quantity-based scheduling, application and management of corporate norms, conditional scheduling, skill scheduling, costed material leveling, that is unique, no other software does it, resource critical path calculation, unlimited number of cost components, ability to manage parallel budgets of the same projects, unlimited number of work breakdown structures, resource breakdown structures, material breakdown structures. Spider Project keeps project archives and does trend analysis for any parameter. It includes quantitative risk analysis that can be applied to the schedules with resource and data constraints. And a lot of features that I can list, but we do not have enough time to discuss them all. We will discuss some of unique features of Spider Project in the next order. We will start with initial data for schedule model. Then we will consider project scheduling, project budgeting, risk simulation, performance analysis, portfolio management, and reporting. A good project model must reflect the reality. I mean that activity properties that used in the model shall cover everything that people consider when they plan their jobs, when they plan their projects. Resources and assignments also shall include everything that people consider when they plan their resources. Resources are assigned the same way people do it. Cost shall be assigned the same way people do it. And in most projects, and especially in construction, initial information about activities is the amount of work to be done. We call it activity volume. It is measured in physical units like cubic meters, stones, kilos, etc. And when activity volume is known, activity duration is calculated based on total productivity of assigned resources. A lot of project data and corporate norms are linked with volumes, like material requirements per unit of volume, unit cost, productivity is measured as volume per unit, and Spider Project uses activity volumes as initial information and calculates everything else. But of course, there are also activity type that we call duration. You can enter duration directly, but I repeat that for most activities, initial information is a volume of work to be done. The SPIDER project supports all traditional methods and tools, as I told before. And so it supports four traditional dependencies: start to start, finish to finish, finish to start, start to finish. But we also have what we call double leg dependencies or point-to-point dependencies. You can connect certain point of preceding activity with certain point of succeeding activity. It means that preceding activity, that you shall do some amount of work on preceding activity before the certain part of succeeding activity can proceed. This is two legs, activity dependency with two legs. That is why we call it double legs. It is useful for high-level project scheduling. When project schedule is created, activity got new properties, like if they are driving, it means they define the start of succeeding activity. If they are critical, critical is driving for critical activities. And activity dependencies may have a lot of different properties. Well, for example, they can be mandatory, discretionary, external, etc. And this kind of dependencies may be assigned to dependency, and then you can filter, sort, etc. your dependency based on dependency properties. Dependency legs are usually defined as time legs. You may, for example, decide that the next activity will start after 2 days from the start of preceding activity. But usually, legs mean volume of work that shall be done on preceding activity before next activity starts or finishes. And SPIDER project suggests to use not only time legs, but also volume legs. Time legs are changing because you see the work is never done exactly as planned. And if the work is executed, you need to adjust time legs that exist in your model. But with volume legs, this problem doesn't exist. Sometimes project scope, network dependencies, activity properties, etc., may depend on some conditions. So for example, if we are late, we will assign more resources to some activities and we'll do the rest of the project different way. And this is something that we model using special activities that we call switches. Switch is a activity of zero duration, like milestone, and it has two states, yes or no. If yes, one branch is selected. If no, then another branch of the network is selected. So switch decides how we proceed from this point. And you can change the states of the switch manually or enter some condition, and the software will automatically select how to proceed. And it is very useful in Monte Carlo simulation because you shall simulate not only that some risk happened, but also what people will do if the risk happened, risk responses. And switch helps, for example, to model that people will accelerate the execution if switch activity is late to some predefined date. Another type of activity that is unusual is trigger. Trigger actually models risk event. Trigger activity is zero duration activity that have certain probability to happen. When trigger activity occurs, the project may proceed in different ways, and each way with certain probability. Trigger activities are used in Monte Carlo simulation, but when you look and analyze deterministic schedule, then you can select some trigger position, and changing this position, you can play with what-if scenarios. Project resources are divided into two types: renewable resources and consumable resources. Renewable resources are people or machines. These resources can be used again after they finish their work. And material resources or consumable resources just disappear when they were used. And they're totally different, and that is why in Spider Project it's not the type of resources, but different objects. And you can assign materials to resources. For example, you can assign gas to the car, and define that car consumes gas when it works. And as a result, Spider will calculate the requirements for gas. Another option with resource planning is assigning not resources, but skills. You can create the list of resources that have certain skills, assign skills to activities, and when Spider Project will calculate project schedule, it will select what resource will do what, based on resource skills, resource availability, resource productivity, resource cost. We call this skill scheduling. And another option is to create and assign resource crews. We call these crews multi-resources. When you assign resource crew, you automatically assign all resources that belong to this crew. Resource assignments may be partial. For example, I will assign somebody for 20% of his or her work time. And Spider Project calculates, simulates partial assignments. And when we assign resources, we assign quantities and workload. It is not enough to assign total workload, like 200% of some resource. You just do not know if this is two resources with 100% workload or four resources with 15% workload. And so in Spider Project, you will have separate reports, and you will separately calculate resource quantities and resource workload and workup, man hours, etc. Some activities can be performed by variable crews. I mean that, for example, you can assign not certain amount of workers to some activity, but a range. For example, this work can start if five workers will be available and assigned. But if additional workers will become available, they will join and accelerate activity execution, but activity does not need more than eight workers. And so we assign these ranges, and Spider Project optimizes resource usage, assigning all available resources that that fit to those restrictions. There are two types of resource assignments, teamed and independent. Team assignment means that all resources that belong to the team work together, and if one member of the team is not available, the whole team will wait and will not do the work because they work only together. Independent assignments means that each resource works by its own calendars and its only this and its availability periods. So the assigned resources may work at different times. And independent resource assignments is useful for simulating work in several shifts. And Spider Project can plan projects and work in several shifts. Project cost consists of cost components, and Spider Project can manage any number of cost components in your project. And examples of cost components are cost of materials, cost of machines, salaries, indirect costs, etc. There are several types of cost assignments. You can assign cost as fixed per work hour or per work per activity volume unit. And cost may be assigned to activities, to resources, materials, and to resource assignments. Using volumes and volume units permits to build a bridge between estimating and project model. Because when you created databases of unit cost, it can be linked with the project model, and if activity volumes changed, automatically changed its cost, and if unit cost is changing, then automatically will change the cost in the project that linked with these databases, with this reference book, as we call it. And Spider Project simulates not only expenses, but also revenues. With this option, project planners can manage not only project expenses and project budgets, but also project cash flows. And as I already told, Spider Project permits to manage parallel budgets in your project. For example, one budget is your expenses, another budget is contract costs, and you can create any number of them. Corporate reference books include resource dictionary, material dictionary, different kind of norms like material requirements per unit of volume. It is very useful because it permits to create corporate project management system. It is right if the same activities in different projects are estimated the same way. Changing data in the reference books, you will change the future data, the future part of the projects for all projects that are linked with these reference books. And in this slide, you see examples of reference books, like productivity on typical assignments, resource productivity on typical assignments, material requirements per unit of volume. We also recommend to create typical fragment library. Typical fragment is a small project that describes the work on work package. Like, for example, construction of 100 meters of road, construction of external wall, etc. And when such library exists, creating project models became easy. You create WBS, you replace work breakdown work packages in this work breakdown structure by typical fragments. You link activities of different fragments And that's all. Your model is ready. Your fragments, resources were assigned, cost was assigned, materials were assigned, and when the fragment is included in the project model, everything includes also. Spider project includes all ways of project schedule analysis. There are a lot of predefined filters like showing, for example, activities that do not have predecessors, activities that do not have successor, activities that precedes to certain activities, or activities that succeeds for certain group of activities, activities that are done out of sequence, anything. And there is a report that we call schedule statistics that shows all this information that can be needed for analysis of project model quality. When initial data were entered and the model created, we can schedule our project, we can calculate project budget, etc. Critical path method is supported by all scheduling tool, and Spider supports it also, but it has some additional functionality that we will discuss. Usually, project management tools calculate traditional critical path, total and free floats, but Spider project also calculates activity drags, activity flexes, and optimizes CPM schedule when increasing some activity durations shortens overall project duration. Drag is a maximum amount of time that one can shorten the activity duration before it is no longer on the critical path or before its duration becomes zero. So drag shows what certain activity adds to project duration. Is it reasonable to shorten duration of this activity or another activity when you consider schedule crashing? You will select activities that can be shortened, and the drag helps to select the right activities. Activity flex shows activity duration flexibility. For example, if I know when activity shall start, I analyze if activity finish can be delayed without delaying any other activity or violating any constraint. So what happens if activity duration will become longer? And this reserves that we call activity flexes can be used for optimizing resource assignments. Maybe I can use less amount of resources on this activity if its flex is sufficient, or another, or resources with less workload, and to use them in parallel on something. And this is helpful when you try to optimize project cost and resource assignments. Usually, we see that activity duration increasing can shorten project duration when you meet negative drag. Negative drag means that if activity duration will become zero, project duration will be increased. And so you can think that maybe if activity duration will be increased, project duration will be shortened. Brad Plotnik suggested to automate this analysis. And in Spider project, you can optimize project schedule if it is possible by increasing activity duration. In this slide, you will see that Papa's schedule was initial schedule with 17.5 days duration, and after automatic optimization, his duration became 12.5 days, and it was achieved by increasing some activity durations. Usually, increasing durations is not a problem. The problem is to make it shorter. Spider project is able to calculate project schedules taking into account all project constraints, not only traditionally renewable resource constraints like labor or machines, but all resource constraints, including material constraints, cost constraints, space constraints, everything. And as I already told, Spider project optimizes resource constraint schedules. The schedules created by Spider project are usually shorter than the schedules created for the same project by other tools. And creating resource constraint schedule, Spider project calculates resource constraint activity floats and resource critical path that may consist of activities that do not link with each other. Activities are resource critical if their delay will delay project finish. It's the same as critical path in traditional sense, but resource critical path may consist of activities that are not logically linked, because some of them are delayed because resource was not available. Resource critical path is also known as critical sequence or critical chain. In this slide, you will see two schedules. At the left, the schedule was calculated by using critical path method. This is a very small project of only four activities and one finish milestone, and it uses only two resources, A and B. And at the left, critical path is activity 1 and 2, but resource A is overallocated, and so activity 1 was delayed, and new resource critical path consists of activity 3, 1, and 2. And dotted arrow from activity 3 to activity 1 shows why activity 1 was delayed. We call this resource dependency. It shows the reason for delay. It's not real dependency. It's just a tool for schedule analysis. Material leveling and cost leveling can be illustrated in this project. It consists of only two activities. Each of them requires 10,000 pieces of some material, for example, bricks. And bricks are supplied on certain days at delivery 1 and delivery 2. And activity 2 was delayed because it was not enough bricks to do it earlier. And this was automatically done, and you will see that below you have diagrams or charts that show material consumption, material supply, and material flow. The same way you can level project with cost constraints. As we discussed earlier, it is useful to manage parallel budgets of the same project. And it is natural to assign, to select very tight schedule for management of your workforce and manage contingency reserves that are created based on risk simulation for management and for reliable achievement or project targets. So you can have several budgets and you can model payments and incomes. And the next slide shows how it looks in the real project. This is construction of certain building, and you will see that there are several budgets, the budget for the team, the budget for the management team, and the budget that is contract budget. And payments are modeled also, and you will see cash flow in the project. This is banana curve, early and late S curves, and everything is helpful for management of real projects. Spider project simulates risks, and project model must include the risk events that we model as triggers and their impacts that lead to different ways of project execution. You remember that trigger selects which branches will be used with what probabilities. And spider project model, risk model, includes probabilistic and conditional branches. Monte Carlo simulation must be applied to this model, and it includes both uncertainty of ranges of initial data and these events that are modeled as triggers. And Spider project can do it, but it also includes simple method of risk analysis, called risk scenarios method. It is very practical and preferable by our users, for our users. But there are two methods that Spider, it's Monte Carlo simulation and risk scenarios method. Loss analysis. What is unique in Spider project? I told you, the Spider project keeps project archives. And so it have the whole history of the project and can retrieve and show you trends of any parameters. And we can see the trends as the main information for project managers for decision making, because negative trend requires some response. You may be ahead of the schedule, for example, for 10 days, but a month ago you were ahead of the schedule for 25 days, and this trend is not very good, and you shall find what happens and decide what actions are needed for improvement. And the most valuable trends are trends of success probabilities. They show what happens with probability to meet project targets. If this probability goes down, it means that your contingency reserves are consumed faster than expected. And if you will not do anything, then your contingency reserves will be exhausted too early. What different in analysis of success probability trends if to compare with traditional methods of project analysis like on-value analysis, variance analysis, etc. Success probability trends look to the future. Traditional methods analyze past performance and make some conclusions from the analysis of past performance. You, for example, may perfectly execute your project, but you discovered new risks, and you included these new risks in your model, and success probability went down, and you will see that you have problem looking at success probability trends. But status will not show that anything wrong was happened. So this is how it looks in the real project. You see success probability trends that show was okay when you have problems. And at the top, you see the trend of the forecast of overall project cost. And you will see that you have additional expenses and then you saved some money. You have the whole history and the trends. Spider project portfolio planning includes portfolio resource supply and financing constraint scheduling. And this scheduling takes into account project priorities. You see, we apply the same methods to portfolio management as we apply to the projects. And it is necessary to be able to manage portfolio cash flow, to take into account all existing constraints when you select your projects, when you manage your projects in the portfolio, and strategic project planning. It is necessary to be able to calculate net present value, internal rate of return, payback period, to consider activity, to consider cost discounting, cost escalation, the possibility to reinvest, and everything, all of this is included in SPIDER project method and project management. Okay. Let's look at examples of SPIDER project reports. What is new in SPIDER project reports? Well, actually, a lot of reports can be created, a lot of different reports. There is a list and handouts. You can look at this. We just don't have enough time to discuss each point. This is a resource Gantt chart. It shows when each resource is working in your project, and actually it can be expanded, and you will also see at what activities is each resource worked and how and what volume was planned and done, etc. This is material Gantt chart. You will see when each material was consumed or was consumed or planned to be consumed. This is time location chart. Time location chart is one of SPIDER project standard reports since 1997. This is banana curve. It's actually early and late S curves. And if you are between them, then you have chances to be on time and on the budget. But if you are, you are, for example, higher than this curves, then you have real problems. This is comparative probability curves. You create probability distribution for activity duration, and you can compare these probability distributions of current version of the project and some of previous versions, for example, with this baseline distribution. This is a scatter diagram. It shows probability to meet both targets together. For example, to meet duration target and to meet cost target. Separate probabilities may be high, but to meet both targets will be harder. And this diagram is used and shows probability to meet both targets together. You have also seen success probability trends. This is another example of success probability trends. This is project dashboards. Not spider project means to create any dashboard and keep them and report them, and it's not something that is not possible. Okay, I expect that you may have some questions, so I left 5 minutes for your questions. You can ask them in the chat, or you can ask them later in the cafe. So do you have any questions?
Yes, we do have questions.
Okay.
Faisal Al-Malki is asking, is it can be integrated with SAP to collect the data?
Please repeat, because the sound was bad.
Is it can be integrated with SAP to collect the data?
Sorry, I don't hear. I have heard to collect the data, but I did not hear what was first. Is it? And then the sound.
Is it can be integrated with SAP to collect the data?
Yes, yes. Spider project can be integrated with anything. Just anything. It's very easy, and it is integrated with ERP system and with, for example, Power BI. You can use anything for integration. And
we have second question. Easy. How can we try our hands on Spider project team?
Dim? Did I understood that you asked about BIM? Actually, we are developing some functionality, and it's will appear very soon to show import information from IFC files and show project schedule in 4D, 4D, 5D, 6D, everything. But at the moment, you can easily export Spider project schedules to Navisworks. And I know that some of our customers export Spider project data to Synchro. So it's very easy to connect Spider project with any other software. But we are developing our own tool, and it will be ready, I think, in the spring. Okay. If you do not have other questions, then thank you very much for attending, and download handouts. If you will have any questions, my email is on the last screen, so you can write to me and you can discuss anything with me at this conference. There is a chat, conference, cafe, networking cafe. Thank you.